bear with me while I scratch all the name changes here. So welcome, guys. My name is Craig. I'll be flying around the island here for the next 50 minutes or so. A couple things I want to talk about before we depart. First of all is the safety briefing. You received a safety briefing on the inside of the office there. If you have any questions on that, now is the time to ask. Now, next, you can feel air going out of above us here. That's the air conditioning vents. However, the air conditioner does not turn on until we actually leave the ground. Then it's going to get real cold real quick. Last but not least, the microphones. Everybody's sharing microphones, except Kazer up front and Hera. They've got their own here. But everybody in the back is sharing them. To operate them properly, press and hold that black button. Hold them very, very close. Speak forcefully into them. For takeoff and landing, I'm going to turn them off. So sit back, relax, and we're going to get out of here. Over Kalapaki Beach here. Got the Marriott down on the right-hand side. And Norwegian Cruise Lines. Is there anybody in here off the ship? Everybody's a ship, okay. Well, there you go. You're home away from home. You're going to be here till tomorrow afternoon and then hang around and sail up to the north and the west side of the island. Everybody's mics are back on. We're at our cruise. Sail away from me. Oh, oh, gravity has taken better than me.
me where the light is. Just keep me where the light is.
Kara, where are you and Kaiser from?
Florida.
Florida, where at Florida?
Daytona Beach.
Daytona Beach, nice. So you come all the way out to the same type of weather out here?
Yes, not missing home, one paradise weather.
There you go. Every time I ask somebody, why did you travel from Florida to come here, 100% of the time they say mountains. Coming into view on the left-hand side is a big old half-moon bay known as Keybine. You ever saw the movie The Descendants? That movie is based on the history of this property. And of course it was used in the movie. It's only owned by the Waterhouse family. The state of Hawaii is going to obtain it for free here in about 7 years, and when they do, they can never develop it. Veronica, where are you and Robert from?
We are from northern Michigan.
Ooh, what's the weather like there today?
Probably in the teens and snowing.
Beverly, how about you and Norman?
We're from Iowa, and ditto for the weather.
Oops, so. I moved here to escape the terrible, terrible weather of Southern California. It's actually colder here sometimes than it is where I used to live. On the left-hand side is the resort area of Poipu. If you ever return for an extended visit, and it's during any time during the winter time, you want Poipu out the left-hand side. It is considered the dry and sunny part of the island, and in the winter time it rains a lot up on the north shore. In fact, we may get a little light rainstorm this afternoon. You Jurassic Park fans, this field on the right-hand side was used in the first two movies, various locations of it. And starting to film in about a month, Jurassic World, the fourth movie in that series. It'll be ready to be released in summer of 2015. I'm sorry, say that again? Yeah, they're going to make a new Jurassic Park movie, well, Jurassic World. For you big city folk, if you look at the left-hand side of the aircraft, this is how we live on Kauai. One tiny little another dotting the south shore, the east shore, and the north side of the island. 70% of our island's uninhabited, very much like the Big Island. And in fact, there's no roads into the interior here. You'll get in here is by aircraft. So that's where we're heading. So into the Hanapepe Valley we go. We're going to start picking up all of our little waterfalls here. Keep them with us the rest of our flight. And this big old one off the nose, Manavaya Puna. This waterfall was used in the first Jurassic Park film right at the beginning. And for everybody in the back, I'm going to slow down and put it out all sides of the aircraft so everybody can get a great view here. It is 360 feet tall. There are falls above it.
For Norman, if we get a movie, you don't need to take 100 pictures.
Did you get that, Norman? If not, I can get you. I thought my wife was on board for a second here. The mountain out the right-hand side, going up into the clouds. Mount Kautini. It's our tallest point on the island. It's one of the rainiest spots on Earth up there. For 400 inches of rain every single year. So the next time it starts pouring rain, wherever you're raining, think of us here. So we're heading out westbound over the southern interior. A lot of people ask me what type of wild animals on Kauai. We have pig and boar everywhere, and I mean everywhere. From the middle of our island to the western shore, we have thousands of wild goats. And then at the top of our large canyon here on the island, we have black-tailed deer. That's it. There's nothing predatory here on the island. No bear, mountain lion, or bobcat, or anything like that. It has been rumored that there are chickens on the island. We're still looking for them.
Way up high, and love that you dream of once in a lullaby.
So we're going to start leaving the lushness of the island and get a little drier and redder. This is the Olokele Canyon. It is very pristine. There's really no human interaction into the canyon. There's no roads or trail for anybody to get up in here.
Dream that you did too, oh why, oh why.
So off our nose as we leave the Olokili is the Waimea Canyon. This is our largest canyon on the island, all accessible by the public. In fact, there's hiking and camping, a little restaurant and a museum up at the top of the canyon. Largest canyon on the island and the largest in the Pacific. All the red dirt you see is iron oxide, nothing more than common rust. You ever notice our car's bottom are all red? That's from driving on the dirt roads. For hikers on the island, this is the place to do it. Over 40 miles worth of trails. One of them is called the Canyon Trail, and it takes you right to the little waterfalls on the right-hand side, known as Waipo'o Falls. As we get close to it, you'll probably see some folks there on the edge. Kick out of watching these people walk right to the edge. Kind of slopes away from where they're at so they can't see the pure cliffs that's in front of them. And they knew. So our last little look at the canyon here. Kara, how are you doing over there?
Good.
All right.
Beautiful.
It is absolutely gorgeous out here. But the best is yet to come. Pass a little paved road underneath us where it brings everybody up here. Off our nose, the white buildings along the coast is Barking Sands Navy. It is the only military base we have on the island, marks the end of the paved road. As you guys cruised around the Hawaiian Islands and looked at the maps of the islands, you probably have noted on every single island there's a geographical feature that prevents a road from being built around the outer perimeter of every island. on this island is called the Nepali Coast.
The shores of the sea. It's a typical situation, it's typical times. Too many choices, yeah. It's a typical situation, it means typical times. Too many choices. Everybody's happy, everybody's free. Keep the big door open, everyone will come around. Different. Why are you that way? If you don't get in line, we'll lock you away. It all comes down to you.
Part of the Navy base is Makar Ridge on the left-hand side, all the little radar facilities.
Sense of sound, four seasons turn on and turn on. I can see three corners from this corner. Two's a perfect number, but one. Everybody's happy, everybody's free. We'll keep the big door open. Everyone.
The Nepali Coast and the water conditions out here are just spectacular. Nice and calm. When we come over this ridge here, look down at the ocean, you'll actually see the bottom. Lightest color you see is sand. Everything else is coral reef. So welcome to the Nepali.